Right out, but it looks like we're finally hopping into it. We don't know what the bands are. They did not appear on the screen, but that is A-okay. We are hopping right into the action right here.
Yeah, dude.
Stadium, typical.
Stadium 2, man.
Rocking the dank Samus as opposed to the non-dank Samus.
Yeah,
some people prefer that low level dash attack.
Right.
Or the low profile dash attack, as you know. You know what I mean.
I like the way Waves is just chilling in the back, man. He's got his cannon ready to shoot, so if the red team overcommits, he's ready to let it rip just like that, man.
Yeah, I can already see, you know, Snake already has, like, a lot of coverage on his own. But with Snake, you know, putting all these explosions everywhere, trying to cover as many options as he can. And on the back of that, Waves just charging a neutral B to, like, be able to take out stocks as, like, their stock closer, if you would. I can see this being a pretty effective team dynamic right now. But the up smash, not going to take out either of those players right there as Hakuru is launched off stage.
Waves looking for an edge guard, too. Let's see what he can find. Nice job using the charge shot in Odyssey 2, paying attention to both players. So important in doubles, but Pelka with a little team fire. Not enough to KO, though. I mean, that's the thing about this team. The blue team, tons of projectiles, a lot of weight, too. Like, that's a hefty team right there. They're not going to die very easily. A little stalling going on. Good tech. It looked like he teched. Yeah, he definitely did.
Yeah, but you got to watch yourself on these platforms. Not just because of Lucina with her up tilt and her just her general juggling power. Fox's up smash does go through the platforms here on Pokemon Stadium 2. Despite it even being higher platforms than Pokemon Stadium 1. So you got to watch your landings on these platforms, not just because of Lucina, but because of Fox as well. We'll see how they're going to be able to do that. And that's rough for Snake as well, because his biggest, you know, blunder as a character is that his disadvantage is relatively weak. Once he's in the air with that Cypher, he can get juggled relatively easily, so...
Did Pelka just marry and then blow himself up with a C4?
Probably.
Yes. 100%, dude. That's exactly what happened. Look at Waves, dude. 171. That is amazing, because that's going to be a lot of rage and see what he can do with it. Big stocks for him in Odyssey right now. Nair, other side, not enough to KO. Good shield work there, avoiding the king, the killing blow. Oh my god, the
side,
Waves going deep. That was amazing.
And I don't know if you saw that play on the other side of the stage as well. Adi actually putting a shine out to the Snake up smash right there. So when it came down, Snake was not able to get away from it, and that did wind up killing Pelka right there. Really good option from Odyssey to be able to do that as the up B out of shield kills him.
Ooh, oh my god.
Waves actually putting in more work right there, watching him down.
He still has all three stocks. And as I said that, he was getting hit, but he lived, dude. Fighting his way off. Forward air living. He's going to be at 200 by the time he goes, man. This stock is ready to pop any moment. But Waves saying, you know what, I'm going to hold on to it. I'm going to use this rage. Man, I really like the way Waves is playing doubles, man. He's definitely the MVP right now, especially if blue team wins this game. But there you go, Odyssey getting the clean punish there. Up smash, taking out Waves' first stock. He was deep in the red, though. Okay, good job by Odyssey again, but this is the big advantage to having Waves be the stock tank, dude. Pelka's gets a pop back down. Now look at the situation for the blue team. It's so good.
Yeah, dash attack launching both of them off stage right there. Snake regaining stage control, putting the bombs where he has to, just like right there with the C4. Able to take the stock right there. First game is going to go to the blue team in Pelka and Waves.
That was nutty, dude. Obviously, I got to give an MVP gold star to Waves for that one. Living at 200% his first stock. Pelka dying, you know, taking the extra stock. But that's, dude, that's how teams works. They're letting Pelka go in. I feel like Waves got beat up initially on his first stock. He was at, like, 90 very early on. And then what happened is he chilled back. Pelka kind of handling a 2v1. Like, Snake can kind of do that because he can trade with people. You know, he's got grenades. He's got explosives to cover himself. Pretty good hitboxes and all that stuff. But they let Pelka be the tank. And then also Waves is like stock tanking. You see what I'm saying? Like, Pelka ran in, he took all the damage, and Waves goes, that's cool, man. I'm absolutely
loving that team dynamic, like you said before. And it's good with Snake being the aggressor, not just because of his coverage or all the explosive. Snake is a heavy lad, so he's going to be the one who's eating most of the heat, and you know he'll live a lot longer than Waves did as Dark Samus. But like you said, because Dark Samus was the one holding back, since Waves is the one holding back, he is the one who actually winds up being the stock tank at the end of the day, even though he's the lighter character. It's a really interesting dynamic that they have right there. And I'm looking forward to see how Odyssey and Hakuru wind up adapting to it.
Between Snake and Dark Samus, Snake is 106 weight, and Dark Samus is clocking in at 108. So they're very close in terms of weight.
Oh.
So it's not like, dude.
So Dark Samus is actually heavier?
Yeah.
According to
the information I have, that's what I have. But they're like tied. Let's be real for a second.
I mean,
two units of weight, really not going to make that much difference.
You know.
But like, for the red team, that's what Hack was, right? They're the red team?
Hakuru and Odyssey were the red team.
Red, okay. So the red team, like, you can't really be like, let's focus this one or let's focus that one based on their weight. Like, it's not really a thing that can happen. Like, they're both, either way, like, you're damned if you do, damned if you don't. Because if you go after Samus, Snake's throwing projectiles at you, and Samus has an up B as a get off me option. Snake, on the other hand, if you go after Snake, you just pull grenades, dude. And if you're trading with Snake, especially his light character like Fox, it's not good. This team is super annoying.
And I don't know if we're seeing any switches come out yet. I haven't heard anything. There's no screen right now. fans, and here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Game number two. Is this still best of three territory? I do believe it. This is losers top eight, it says, so I'm not quite sure if we're still in best of three territory or if this is best of five, but either way, we'll see what these guys are going to be able to do here. A little bit of a color change coming out from Waves right now. Pokemon Stadium is still the pick. C4 on the platform. Odyssey, you better be... Actually, not even Odyssey. Acro, you better be careful. Landing right there. There we go. This is what I like to call the cluster ball of dubs.
Yeah.
When there's nothing you can commentate on. He's got done. Oh, and the back air from Odyssey.
Totally.
Oh, but he's getting saved by his teammate
much,
Hacker right there.
This
is where, you know, you just gotta chill for a second. Wait for one team, the blue team, to regain stage control for a second.
All it really means is that there's a lot of action going on, and like it's kind of speaking for itself, to be honest with you.
Yeah.
But here we go. Pelka trying to recover. On the other side, we got Waves going for an edge guard. Instead, he's dropping a stock very early. Very, very different situation than game one. Pelka now taking the role as a stock tank. Saw that immediately right when Waves dropped the stock. Pelka kind of ran away and chilled. He's just hanging out. Hold on. So now Pelka's going to try to hold on to some rage, try to get an up tilt KO. Odyssey, up smash. Oh my god, that killed Snake at like 97.
Fox's up smash is, it's something else in this game has. I mean, Fox's
so
up smash is Fox's up smash. It's always been amazing. But this game, with that falling Nair confirmed like he's had in prior games, it's just, that will kill you reliably regardless of your weight, my friend.
That's right.
All right, so red team with a little bit of a lead right here. Both of them at kill percent right now, but they are both still on their first stocks. Forward tilt from Snake, not launching his teammate off stage right now, but there's a lot of percent tacking on right now as the neutral beat. We'll finish off Odyssey's first stock.
Nice! Hack getting a little aggressive off stage. I think he was actually dead,
but like that hitbox he put out saved him, and now all of a sudden he had a lot more time to drift in the air and just like make his way back with a good DI.
Waves to the ledge here. Blue team in a situation we're trying to edge guard.
They are just sandwiching. That's a snake sandwich right now. I don't know. I've never had one of those before in my life. It sounds relatively delicious, and that is exactly what the blue team is trying to cook up for you right now. Both of them recognizing that Waves was on the other side of the stage, off of the ledge, trying to recover. So they tried to just bombard Snake, get as much damage on him as possible, and potentially kill him.
Look at that. Pelka was pinned between the two red team members. Oh, God. Odyssey just running up and up smashing. Very clutch stuff. Red team running away with this one. As Odyssey said, come at me.
Red team with stage control and stock leads right now. Only 4% on Hakuru right now. Looking like a much different situation than the last game, ladies and gentlemen.
See the movement from Hakuru? Look at that. He just left Pelka alone. He goes, you know what? I got to help my man Odyssey out. That's great. I'm telling you, Hakuru has some amazing awareness and doubles for sure.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah.
It's really good.
And he kind of, ooh, the neutral beat takes the stock right there. He kind of has to, considering their strategy is for him to be the sort of the passive one, for him to be the one to hold back. In a sense, it is his job to be watching what's going on to his teammate to make sure while he's the one who's doing the fighting that he's okay. So far, it looks like the red team has definitely caught onto that strategy, and they are still fairly soundly in the lead right now with Odyssey still holding onto that stock right now with the stock lead.
We're going to see
the C4 actually finishing it out.
You talk about amazing doubles awareness. Look at Pelka right there. Literally the other side of the map with the C4. So amazing. Odyssey is just swanging over there, dude. Up smashing over and over, trying to get Waves, but Waves, such a good defensive player, dude. You got to be if you're playing a Samus. Okay. Oh my god, blue team helping each other out right there. Oh my god, they're just rotating on the ledge. That is going to be enough. Double KO by the red team. Taking that one down 1-1. Very good stuff by Odyssey and Hack. Good adjustment.
And the light taunt to finish it. It's okay, man. You know, it's just, you have a drinking problem.
Take it easy, man. I had to take it easy.
All right.
Game three. Is this best of five? Did we get confirmation? Yes, it is best of five.
This is best of five. All right, we are in top eight.
That's true.
Yeah.
So
I mean, I asked Devin before. He deliberately ignored me. Deliberately.
He does that all the time.
Deliberately.
He does it all the time.
I love you, Devin.
Like I said, he's lucky.
He gave me the hand. That's
he's
all right.
Lucky it's his birthday.
Honestly.
All I got to say, dude.
Really the luckiest guy in the world.
All right, man. So
where are we going?
Let's find out. Blue team really thinking about it. I feel like... I want to see the bands, actually. Like, that's what I'm most interested in. I feel like they're not going to do it, but okay.
Wow,
we're not going to see anything.
3K, man, you know.
Cowards. Use the tablet.
Wow. Oh, they're just not using the tablet. That's why that's not appearing.
Yeah.
That is cowardly.
I know.
Yeah, dude, come on.
Just use your finger, man.
It's not hard.
It's obviously not hard to do.
Do they not want the stream? seem to know what they're doing.
They don't care about the chat, which is ridiculous.
They're trying to counterpick you guys, chat.
Oh, it looks like the surprise pick is going to be regular Samus is the switch, but wearing the dark. Okay, I don't know, man.
Pretty much literally only one difference in the dash attack. He has his jump, so he's okay.
Dude,
well,
I like
a wonderful edge guard regardless.
Dude, he's getting so aggressive off stage. I love it. And that's the thing is, like, Samus doesn't really have a lot of good, like, get off me options that far away from her, from the stage. Up B is obviously a good go to when you're on stage and can land underneath you, but man, that, oh my god, the early stock too. Oh, Jesus, dude.
Yeah.
What the heck?
Down goes Adi right there, and down goes Pelka. No, yeah. I thought he was going to be able to get the C4 out. Not in time, just a little bit too low below Smash Zone.
It was already, yeah, it was already on the platform. So he actually blew up waves while he was trying to recover, which sucks. Because, like, he had to try something, but that was definitely not the option.
Really good awareness from waves right there, saving his teammate, hitting Hakuru with a fully charged neutral beam. Aggressive edge guard coming out. Good ledge drop right there with the back there. That move is still, in fact, DLC, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah, hack off stage has been amazing so far. And there's, where'd he go? Never mind. He's not, he didn't like that stock. It's got
to
be made.
He was just so amazing off stage that he wanted to go even further.
That's right. He wanted to see, this is to go even further.
Yeah, just go to the blast zone. That's as far off stage as you can get.
True. There you go. Chaos in the center right here. I mean, Smashville's just a stage and doubles. It's really going to lend itself to have a lot of chaos, especially when you got grenades being chucked every which way by Snake.
Here a lot of grenades being chucked around, a sword on the scene, man. There's a lot of hitboxes going around.
Not only that, but, like, obviously Samus has her own set of explosives and charge shots and, like, all these other things flying out, but it's Odyssey, if you can find. On the hunt, yep, running up and up smashing. Great awareness. He just sat in the back and waited, dude. It's so smart. There, looking for follow-up. I like that. Odyssey, instead of keeping the pressure up on the ledge against waves, opted to go and help out Hefaru. Heck.
He exploded.
Yeah,
he just exploded. It's
alright. Relatively even, though. I mean, if Hakaru dies here. Oh, back air? Hold on. Okay. Good defense. Hakaru defending. Man, defending Odyssey 100% there. Very nice.
Really good spot dodge coming out from Waves right there, recognizing the situation, seeing that Odyssey was fully charging a forward smash right there to try and save his teammate. He tried to hold on to his teammate as much as tried to hold on to his opponent as much as he could, so he would be the one to get hit by the forward smash. But neither of those players fell for it in that situation. No one gets punished. It's pinball, man. You know, we're at the arcades right now.
He dragged him all the way down. That was a crazy option. I mean, he could recover from it though. So hold on. Oh god. That's exactly where the red team wants a Snake, in between the two of them, and just ping him back and forth. And there, into forward air, and there. Like, there's a lot of different options. Forward tilt. Like, they got a lot of combo potential with this silver-ish team on the red color. Okay.
And Odyssey, of course, being the aggressor right now with the lower percents, Hakuru hanging back. This is going to be the one that Pelka wants to get rid of right now. But of course, team strategy, you know, simple. I'm at the higher percent. I'm going to hang back. You see him going for him right now, trying to actually bait him to approach him for a second there, planning the C4 down. Not going to work. And the falling up air from Odyssey going to be able to take that stock and take that match. 2-1 for the red team right now.
Pelka was playing that 2v1 really well. I feel like Snake is a character that has some potential to do a 2v1. He's got a lot of things that he can pull out of his pocket, including grenades. C4 to cover himself. Like, if he wants to try to land safely, drop out the C4, try to land near it, and try to defend yourself. So I feel like he's doing a good job, but Odyssey, with the up air closing it out, going to be moving on to game four. Red team looking poised to take the set. The adjustments after game one have been monumental. I think the offstage pressure from Hack has been so good against Waves. Like, he's just not letting Waves charge the charge shot, get him free, just sit back and, you know, kind of be a sniper in the background, you know?
Yeah. Absolutely. And look, they're using the tablet.
Thanks, guys.
I think Kalos is laughing about it right now. They just noticed. Kudos to them, man. So Kalos, whatever, and Yoshi's both gone. I think we are still headed to Pokemon, though. I still hear Pokemon music.
For sure.
Yeah. And here we go. Let's get into it. Red team, one more to be able to advance into the losers, further into the losers bracket. Blue team, one more, and they are out of this tournament. And I believe seventh place. Go! Here we go. Pokemon is a pick. Dark Samus is back again. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen.
Good string right there from Waves to start up the action strong. The air dodge down and then punishing Odyssey, very nice. But there's Hack again, man. I'm telling you, Hack is everywhere. That's seriously the biggest difference. Like, Hack's aggression has been really, really good. And awareness.
Absolutely. Say the least, I mean, Hack, it's different, like, you know, like, which one of these guys is going to be the aggressive step back against the stock for the red team. Because we know the blue team strategy already. For the red team, I mean, it's interesting to see their dynamic, because Lucina can definitely close out stocks relatively easily. And so can Fox right there. Lucina with her backer, of course. So it's interesting to see like how like which one of these players are going to be passive as opposed to the blue team. You know?
See, Waves just turn around and walk away. He goes, you know, heck, I'm not talking to you right now. Like we're in a fight. He just turned around and just walked a little bit. That was awesome.
Sometimes it is better to walk and not run, ladies and gentlemen. It can put you in a better position and make it easier for you to get your tilts out or your inputs out when you need them.
Not only that, but I feel like with Samus, her hurt box shift forward. And maybe, like, I don't know, man. Like, I don't know if he did it on purpose or not. Like, maybe he's just walking. You know, maybe it was a misinput or something, but it really worked out. But either way, Hack dropping a stock right there. Red team, you know, kind of down big time right here. And again, we're just seeing Waves take off with this stock tanking strategy.
Yeah, again, still no stock. I mean, Dark Samus and Samus are, of course, the same regular weight, but, like, of course, that's not going to make too much of a difference. But, I mean, with the way that he's been surviving, specifically with Dark Samus, you would think otherwise.
Oh, God. I like that attempt right there. Nair into the follow-up, but Waves can't find anything. Here comes a 2v1 from the red team. Nice Audi looking for the reflector. Can't find it, though. Here we go.
And I love Waves just hanging back, you know, not just with these, like, these lasers and, like, these side beats and everything. But whenever he senses danger, he just hangs. He just jumps backwards and there's the ledge to be able to swing back down a little bit. Putting himself back down below the platform, causing whoever's like whoever on the red team is attacking to go and try and poke the snake again. As that C4 is going to be able to finish Hackaroo's second to last stock right there. Blue team looking very poised, now incredibly poised to be able to take this game.
Oh god,
the both back on their second stock still.
The back-to-back baits were amazing there. They had Samus charging the charge shot with a C4 right in front of Snake and Samus. Second hack approach, they just blew up the C4 and got him. It's a really good bait, man. So seeing the blue team, that this game's a wrap. We're going to game 5. Like, that's
yeah, we're going to game 5. So how was your day,
dude?
How's
it was going so far. I had a great day, man. I'm tired. Oh,
thank you so much.
Wait.
Yeah, oh, wait.
Wait.
Okay. Okay.
My boy's gonna
he
do me
heard
like
us.
This. Oh god, that was
hard.
That hurt.
Here we go. Doesn't matter which one of these guys is the aggressor now. They are both at 0%.
Oh, did he stick him?
Yeah, I think
okay,
he did.
I did not see that
by accident. Both these guys trying to finish off the stock right now.
Stuck.
Sticking his teammate right there and the shield to try and mix it up.
What a scary thing, because you don't want to stay far away from Samus because she can just charge her charge shot. But if you get close, she's got a C4 on her. Like, oh, what a situation, man.
It's like, what do you do?
Yeah. You lose. You go on to game 5. That's what you do. Okay. Hack and Audi having some words. Sure they're going to figure out where they're going to be going next to this game 5 finale. Very, very tight set between these players. It's been a 2-1 so far in terms of wins. Pelka and Waves taking games 1 and 4, and then also Hack and Audi taking games 2 and 3. So it's going to be really like momentum has been swinging back and forth kind of
so
crazy, yeah.
Much adaptation from both of these teams right now, especially considering that order that you just described. Let's take a look at these bands right now, Hazmat, and we shall theorycraft. If they use the tablet.
They're not using the tablet.
They use the tablet a sec. I'm tight. I'm really. My throat is tight.
They're focused.
My personality is tight. I'm tight. Why aren't you using it? I want to talk about, you know.
It's like, we have the technology, you know? Like, you should definitely start using it. Oh, yeah.
Oh, that was a SpongeBob reference for all you young children out there. Anyway.
There you go. SpongeBob for the fans.
Had to put one out there for the fans. I'll be your Koopa just for a minute.
Appreciate that. Anyway, here we go. Game 5.
Like
Odyssey starting it up very strong. 40% on the snake. Like sometimes the snake though, you gotta eat it. Like it's just gonna happen. Especially if your position, you know, under or above a fox, it's just not gonna be good.
Now I really feel like the stage is gonna benefit both teams because a lot of wide open space for you know for Waves to be able to do everything he has to do, for him to be the passive player, for him to charge those neutral bees. Plenty of space for Snake to be able to mix up his landing options as well, like, so he could probably mix himself up with advantage. And even if he doesn't do that too well because Snake's disadvantage is quite bad, we are on Town and City, which is the highest vertical ceiling of all of the legal stages that we currently have, which is another thing. But,
oh no!
Oh god, that was a pinball. Did you see that?
Yeah, that was a good conversion. A good awareness right there from Adi going off of the charge shot from Waves. Here's the thing though, like, up until Pelka lost that stock, yeah, Pelka was at a high percentage, but if you average the two teams' damage out, since Waves was so low, he was like 50-ish at that point. It was very, very good. All right. Here we go, more action coming out. Odyssey, good amount of rage here. Gonna be looking for an up smash. Okay, nice job by Pelka though. Okay, oh,
well, there you go. What are you doing? Yo.
Dead it.
Is it still on him?
Oh, goodness. Dude, you're so smart.
He didn't detonate it. I think the C4 was still on him. He could have saved his teammate right there.
They would have, the levels of awareness right there from, that would have been required from Waves, 100% would have been amazing. And Pelka too, obviously, but like.
Which I think is impressive considering I have absolutely no dubs awareness of my own. But I'm commentating.
You prove yourself wrong, dude. Yeah, that's true. Uppy, so close to the blast zone. Actually, almost taking him off the top. That's craziness. That's the thing about Samus, like, she does have some kind of jank stuff like that, you know, trying to upbeat towards the blast zone, but she also is obviously a very, very good zoner, as we're seeing a lot here. Helka C4ing, kind of hit his own teammate a little bit. I feel like he had a free punish there, too. I think Helka should have just let Waves have the food right there.
This game is relatively even hazmat, but I mean, if, like, if either of these blue people stocks is taken right now, then all of a sudden it, of course, shall not be. But they're doing a pretty good job at staying alive right now, both these players. And the neutral beat? And all of a sudden, stage control is the blue team already. A lot of explosives coming out from Helka right now. Trying to mix up Odyssey right now. He gets him off stage.
Ooh, oh, did you see that?
I did see that. I thought it was
finesse.
Gonna...
That was so good, dude.
I thought
that
the platform was actually going to carry it off.
It bounced off and almost hit Odyssey. That was crazy nice from Helka.
Wow.
It's crazy how fast this blue team can get out of hand. Just like that, though, Helka misfire, hitting his own teammate with a C4. That might be a fatal misstep, to be honest with you. But we'll see.
They got to get rid of these red people stocks right now, Hazmat. And so far, they're looking pretty poised to be able to do that. They're attacking on the percent. Very high kill percent right for both these guys right now. But there's too much damage being tacked on the waves right now.
A lot of it's from Helka, which is really unfortunate because I feel like he's been playing some nice doubles so far. This game 5 might haunt him if they're unable to clean this one up.
Up tilt barely not killing Hakuru right there.
Yeah.
About a percent off.
Next one should do it, though, for sure.
Yeah, they really got to take that stock off of him right now.
Blue team trying to recover, going high. Helka finding his way down. Again, I feel like he's just finding, he's throwing out these big hitboxes and he's just over explosives and he's just finding waves over and over again.
Yeah, I feel like the blue team is losing a little bit of their composure right now. But if they're able to get that back, able to take Hakuru's stock right now, and then Odyssey's, which, you know, they're both, like, getting up there in terms of percent, especially Hakuru. This isn't out of reach just yet. Doubles can turn around like that.
Yeah, and it has a couple times, actually, throughout this game 5. Like, I feel like blue team was down a ton, and now, like, they're still down, but, like, not as much as they were before.
He did stick Dark Samus again.
Fortilt
gone, and there goes Helka as well, and all of a sudden, the 2v1 situation, 143 against Odyssey and Hakuru. This is rough.
Odyssey just retreating too. He goes, Hack, you gotta take the lead here, man. I'm close to KO percentage, and if Waves takes seriously?
It worked!
Okay, all right. Yeah. You know, he just ate more lasers for it, but I like the style. Back throw, should have been an up air, up smash.
I mean, I will say it was close. The platform was getting pretty close.
And he was still rolled up too. Oh, back air, okay. Yep. Nice, clean. Very well played there by Odyssey. And Hack taking it down. Game 5 situation, super clutch play there on Town and City. I loved it. Trying to weave around the projectiles. Hack that time being the stock tank, doing a great job. Pulling it down for the red team, moving on through the bracket. Very well played.
It was honestly wonderful adaptation by both teams, especially towards the end with how seemingly close that game really was. I mean, they each got all of each other down to last stock, but unfortunately for the blue team, it was Odyssey and Hakuru who were able to put themselves back on top. You know, they were just able to get around. They realized that strategy a little slower than we did, but again, we're commentating. So,
That'll happen,
you know, but... Yeah, kudos to them, man. I mean, it was just such wonderful adaptation. And they had their team combos on point, too, in the 2v1s as well with that back air. A lot of people have been saying that team combos are a lot harder in this game with the balloon knockback. You know, they do still exist, though. They are still out there. It just takes a little bit of adaptation, a little bit of practice, getting used to the new engine. If I can even say new engine at this point, this game has been out for about almost 4 months at this point. It's